it.
Exactly.
That's
exactly.
Fine, I'm keeping that shit. Fine. It's going to be the funniest card of the night.
Look, you dick. I already know what the question is.
Who farted?
Put that shit away.
Who just farted?
What
the whole couch just shifted.
What's
Sean?
What?
Was that you?
I'm playing a damn game.
Sean's participating
throw
in the
that card away.
Marathon
throw that
as he shuts the window right after
I'm
somebody
using
farts.
Oh, did they? Somebody drop ass?
Apparently.
My country, tis of thee, sweet land of blank.
Sweet isle?
Sweet isle.
Sweet
land.
Land.
Sweet
land.
Sweet land.
Sweet land of lakes.
Oh, shit.
Sweet land of... Oh, my God.
I'm getting rid of carbs again.
Oh, there's two. Here, I'll just give you that one.
Yeah, that's a chump card.
Chump card?
Chump or trump?
Chump card.
Well, if you're... You have the trump card. I'm holding back on my trump card, then.
I had two good ones.
Chicken to chump.
Chicken to China to Chinese chicken?
Try that one. What the hell?
Is
Chinese
that
chicken?
You turned it back on, right? Well,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we're back.
I have them all.
You should.
I hope so.
Disclaimer. Cards Against Humanity is a work of satire. Please address all complaints and legal threats to former Vice President Dick Cheney.
Nice!
The American Enterprise Institute.
Nice.
All right.
50 cents. That's cool.
My country, tis of thee, sweet land of...
That's not to be rich.
Graphic violence, adult language, and some sexual content.
That's
yeah,
pretty
it's
literal.
Accurate.
That's
yeah.
Pretty literal.
It's very accurate.
Yeah.
Basic human decency.
Who played
that? Definitely.
That's a farce.
Definitely agree with it. You must construct additional pylons. What the fuck does that mean?
We did this, yeah, that's a
seriously?
StarCraft reference. Nerds on stream will get it.
Man.
Construct additional pylons, guys.
I have StarCraft and StarCraft
well,
2 and play them both
Archie.
Religiously.
We
this still
it.
Does not make fucking sense to
I
me.
Know. They zerg you with their nonsense.
Well.
Oh, shit.
So, when he types no, does no mean no or does no mean yes?
It means nothing.
No means kappa.
So there
well,
is
if there are
someone
roofies,
else in the house.
No means nice. Nice.
No means unable to reply. Okay.
Mecha Hitler.
Mecha Hitler.
It's one of my favorite cards.
Z-Guile.
An unhinged Ferris wheel rolling towards the sea. That's very poetic. I think I like that.
Beautiful
one.
Image.
Yes. Yes.
Except with all the people screaming and yelling and
that was,
shitting themselves.
That was the end of 1941.
Hormone injections. All right. I think there's two possible winners here.
The pylons.
No pylons.
No pylons. That was yours then.
I was getting rid of cards.
Yes.
Sauce gets it.
See, Sauce gets it. Take
I'm going for graphic violence, adult language,
Woo!
And some
that
sexual
was,
content.
That was a good literal.
Nice.
Well played, sir.
Giggity, giggity, giggity.
Well played.
All right.
Anybody close to 10?
No, I don't
yeah,
need one.
I was
going
to say, anybody close to 10?
I don't need one.
Nope.
Oh, good. I get a double one.
All right.
I have six.
Are we ready?
I think so.
We are ready.
Bo, everybody down there ready? Sean, you ready?
Yep.
All right. A remarkable new study has shown that chimps have evolved their own primitive version of blank.
Axe wounds. No,
could be.
Sorry.
Do you have that card?
No, I don't.
I would take that as a winner.
I know.
Say it again.
A remarkable new study has shown that chimps have evolved their own primitive version of blank.
I don't have a fucking clue, man.
Right.
Don't know
he's on this level with these dudes, and they're trying
I'm
to kill him.
Just banging away.
All right, do I have all the cards?
Hold on.
I'm hiding from that farmer.
Man. Don't backtalk this.
Wow.
That was dramatic.
Head'll spin. See, I'm not laughing. Right. I don't find it as funny.
Here we go.
That's The Simpsons.
Okay.
Chips have evolved their own primitive version of laying an egg. Nope. This is awesome. You're regretting not taking this one. A remarkable new study has shown that chimps have evolved their own primitive version of Michelle Obama's arms.
I'm not worried about that. It's good. It's
that
good.
Chimps
have
evolved
I
their
have 11 cards.
Chimps have evolved their own primitive version of Joe Biden. Chips have evolved their own primitive version of the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Oh, wow.
The remarkable new studies show that chimps have evolved their own primitive version of George Clooney's Musk.
That's not bad. 60% of the time, it works every time.
Chimps have evolved their own primitive version of scrotal frostbite.
Scrotal stings the nostrils.
Oh, my God.
It stings the nostrils.
Yes, that's the funniest one. I gotta go with Michelle Obama's arm, because racism rules.
God damn it. I was the frostbite.
Who is Michelle Obama?
Who is Michelle Obama?
Oh.
Not me.
That was Mike.
Oh, damn. Mike, you always
win.
Look down.
I have to give up the scar because I have one too many, too. Take it.
Okay.
I didn't look. I just grabbed one at a random.
Okay.
I have 10. I'm good.
No, you're good. Brian, how many do you have?
I have one, I believe.
I have 9.
Dude, at this point, I'm just eating to eat.
Yeah, that's all I was
doing. I'm just eating to stay awake.
Andy,
I
need one.
Why'd you give up one, then?
Because I had too many, I had to give it up. I didn't even look.
You didn't have too many, apparently. You had just the right amount. You gave one up, and then you just got one to replace the one you just gave up. You're supposed to be good at math.
Am I?
Apparently.
You racist.
Where did you find the bunker?
Go ahead, Lou.
I could
go ahead, Lou. I will fuck you.
Oh, my God. Play again, play again.
Do it again.
Oh,
again.
I think it worked out. You
make sergeant less. Very upset. Quiet, though. I will bust your guy to sergeant. Don't pass. That was
close. Because
he's
already a sergeant.
He tells me he's
going to
promote him to sergeant.
Exactly.
He's going to bust him down to sergeant.
I know that Simpsons episode like the back of my fucking...
Oh,
well, penis.
Which side is actually the back of the penis? Anyway, if God didn't want us to enjoy blank, he wouldn't have given us blank.
If he didn't want us to enjoy
blank, he wouldn't have given us blank.
Oh, God. This is... Wow.
Mike?
Right. That's the best. All right, read it to me again. One more time.
If God didn't want us to enjoy blank, he wouldn't have given us blank.
Quiet, Lou, or I will bust you down to second.
It's so funny. He gets mad. Like, first he's like, I'm going to be promoted. And then at the very next turn, he's like, yeah.
All right. Okay. Bo.
Everybody in?
Not yet.
No,
I'm still thinking it over.
Bo, you know, sentence.
It's a double.
Yo,
wait, double. What was it again?
If God didn't want us to enjoy blank, he wouldn't have given us blank. This game is way too elaborate for its own good.
It's really not.
It's really not.
And Bo, the Simpsons reference.
Everybody?
Hi, Stephanie. On stream, my
hi,
sister.
Steph. Hey, Steph.
Hi, Peach.
Allegedly,
Simpsons
my
reference.
Sister.
Princess.
Ending the DNA test.
All right.
Don't
if
forget.
God didn't want us to
okay.
enjoy masturbation, he wouldn't have given us Boris the Soviet love hammer.
Oh,
wait, I thought
wow.
it was a doll.
It is
oh, wait.
A
oh,
okay.
How did you know the name of my shit?
I'm sorry,
Boris.
It's
you
Boris.
Must have written it down
Boris
on this card.
I mean, my shit is rushing even though
Steph,
I'm
Steph, we're playing
sorry.
Cards against humanity, so just bear with us.
If God didn't want us to enjoy whipping a disobedient slave, he wouldn't have given us figgy pudding.
Okay.
If God didn't want us to enjoy being marginalized, he wouldn't have given us daddy's belt. Oh my God. If God didn't want us to enjoy vehicular manslaughter, he wouldn't have given us a sweet spaceship. That one's good.
Enjoy Brit.
If God didn't want us to enjoy weapons grade plutonium, he wouldn't have given us fetal alcohol
could
syndrome.
Be.
Jesus.
Fetal
alcohol.
That's kind of dark.
If God didn't want us to enjoy a 55 gallon drum of lube, he wouldn't have given us pizza in the morning, pizza in the evening, pizza in the summer time. Wow. Oh, God. I like all of these.
Here's a guy that picked us one.
All right. I'm sorry, I gotta go with Boris the Soviet Love Hammer.
Damn it, that was pizza in the morning.
I was almost going for that. I was almost going for that.
Damn. Pizza in the summertime.
Oh, man.
Greatest.
Thank you. I hope I got some good. No?
No.
Bad. I can work with that one.
Does it have to do with race?
It kind of does.
What's
weeds? None of Chuck was? I don't know. Oh, I guess I shouldn't have said that.
That could be totally a racist or a Chuck Norris base.
Chuck Norris action jeans.
Peach is having issues with the video.
Okay, use a different browser, maybe.
I think if she just
how's our,
does the actual...
Bo?
Yeah.
How's our
are you on your phone? Because that shit don't work on the phone.
I just stopped and restarted the stream.
Yeah,
so,
recently.
Yeah, we should be
awesome. How about a Sean there question?
He's being attacked by Imperials right now.
Little Miss Muffet sat on a tub and eating her curds and
your sister.
And your sister.
Trebek.
Oh my god!
If anybody actually has.
I hope I win this one, Sean. So I'm channeling you here.
You're so nice.
Bloody dick.
I'm trying to think. It just makes sense.
Curds and bloody dicks.
It's all about someone's going
right. Right. I was going one way, and then I thought, oh, Sean, I better.
Do we have an extra cardigan? What the hell?
No, we all have hoodies on.
Cardigan,
but thanks for knowing.
Right. V-neck, maybe.
Special musical guest, Cher. Whoa.
No, that's in the running.
He's saving that one.
Like cool ranks?
Oh,
feel the
rhythm.
No! Feel
the
vibe. An albino, a mosquito, my libido. All right. That was a Nirvana.
I know. Mandala of a sour cream and the new Radiohead out. God, that's just fucking gross, but I gotta go with Smegma.
Yes!
Oh! Wow.
That was just
you got the Smegma.
Fuck.
I was getting the Smegma.
There's some black right over here.
That's the black smack.
You've got the leftover
the
uncircumcised fucking penises. That's awesome.
I can't see the video.
Terrible.
Wake up. Oh boy. That's a good one.
Is it?
I don't know.
Steph, can you hear us?
Check my read.
Just can't see us.
Can you hear me?
Papa, can you hear me?
Tell me, can you hear me? Alright, it's Morphin time. Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops, Saber-toothed
tiger,
and blank.
Oh, fucker. I never watched those.
Oh, my God.
Sorry.
I don't know which ones.
That made me lol.
Oh, lol. That would have been a good one too. Him.
More?
Did I get yours?
What?
He's forcing
what?
Some stormtroopers.
Did you?
Yeah,
Sean,
it's Morphin time. Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops.
Did you say?
What? Alright. It's Morphin time. Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops, Saber-toothed tiger.
Just
and a fat bald man
this, right?
From the internet.
Wasn't I? I mean, Mike Horowitz and
Sonny D,
alright! I enjoyed Power Rangers, but I thought I was like, no.
It's Morphin time, Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops, Saber-toothed tiger, and a man in yoga pants with a ponytail and feather earrings.
Feather earrings.
It's Morphin time, Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops, Saber-toothed tiger, and my vagina.
That
would be good.
Ranger.
The Tommy's on. Hello, Tommy.
It's Morphin time, Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops, Saber-toothed
hey,
tiger.
Hey, Tommy. Welcome
it
back, man.
It will explode if it goes under 50 miles an hour.
That's not appropriate for that one.
It's
Morphin
time. Mastodon, Pterodactyl, Triceratops, Saber-toothed tiger, and bitch slap.
Those last three were funny.
What's up, Tommy?
I think I like the bus that will explode if it goes under.
What the fuck?
Because that makes
that
makes no sense.
Damn it, oh, Brian.
Yeah.
Have you won yet?
How many you have, Brian?
No, I haven't won.
How
many
you got?
Always good.
How many you got?
He's got one and a half. Four, five,
5, 6, 7, 8.
Lie.
Eight.
No, no. Right? He's got three.
Three.
Two more for a win.
I wasted my vagina card.
He fucking better say hi. Yeah, you did waste your vagina card. Yeah, well.
I gotta say, it's a regret that a lot of us carry. Is wasting the vagina card.
My vagina, it'll never come back.
Okay, ready?
I've already had it three times, but you know.
My vagina?
Believe it or not, Jim Carrey can do a dead-on impression of blank.
Jim Carrey can do a dead-on impression of
blank. Believe it or not,
Jim Carrey. I'm walking on air. I never thought I could feel so free.
Far away on a wing and a prayer. Who could it be? Believe it or not, it's just me.
We just sang the theme song to a show that hasn't aired in 30 years. That's a spontaneous dorky hookie, right?
When he goes spontaneous,
it was just the three of us, right?
Voicemail message for a while.
We're using open broadcaster, Tommy.
See, you youngins don't know the.
I know the Seinfeld reference.
Yeah, you don't know the original show.
Believe it or not,
Tommy.
I thought Seinfeld was the original.
Yeah, Tommy. We're using open broadcast for this year.
I know what that means.
I think we had a raffle going too that sort of probably disappeared, huh?
Didn't somebody win?
I think you forgot after the started zero a new loco.
I'm like coming back to reality now.
I think I know what's
going to
win
really?
Here. Okay.
So we can run a shot.
Oh no, no more for me.
Okay, believe it or not, Jim Carrey can do a dead-on impression of Nicolas Cage. He can do a dead-on impression of science.
Science.
A dead-on impression of tiny nipples.
Science.
Science.
Oh shit.
Jim Carrey can do a dead-on impression of genetically engineered super soldiers.
Wow.
He can do a dead-on impression of mild autism.
That I believe.
And I think the winner is, believe it or not, Jim Carrey can do a dead-on impression of some really fucked up shit.
Is that really fucked up?
Oh, yes. And I'm going to hear smile off.
Nice work.
Yeah.
One more, and Dan wins.
I only got six.
Because I thought it would have been
I only got six.
Impression of some really fucked up shit.
Plus
three.
Oh, God.
One more, and Dan wins.
Wasn't that yours?
No, I get one.
Well, I looked at this one, so.
Then this one's yours.
Hey, he needs one.
Nine.
Somebody needs one.
I need one.
Count your cards. Count your cards.
I give one to Brian.
One.
I
give
one to Brian.
Did you?
I got ten.
I have nine.
All right, we're good.
I got ten.
All right.
Now I have an extra.
All right, we're good.
What's up, Tommy?
We did not need one.
I don't need
one.
So you took, you gave him two then?
No. Give him one. All right,
this one doesn't.
The question is.
See, I thought mild autism was good because. Since it was believe it or not, you know he can do major autism. Mild autism is another.
You know he can do major.
Being polite in a group will usually get you invited back.
Thanks, Asperger's.
Why are you playing Wow Sauce? Stop it.
Okay. Is everybody ready?
Yes.
Here it goes. This is the easy question. How did Stella get her groove back?
Oh, boy.
Well, I'm pretty sure you were involved, right?
I did the groove in her back.
I got so many good ones.
Oh, shit.
God damn it. Too many good ones hurt. Fuck it. There.
When you get,
Jesus.
That one. When you get, what is it? All sorts of fucked up shit. That's like a trump card.
It is.
You
have everything.
Some really fucked up shit.
Some really fucked up shit.
All right. That's everybody?
No. There's like...
No, I gave them all to you.
We got seven or eight people in chat, by the way.
Okay, we got
six.
Hello, chatters.
We should have at least six.
What's going on, chat?
Exactly.
Six.
What's going on, chat?
How did Stella get her groove back? Bullshit. Is that just a response to the question?
Yes.
Winner.
Bullshit.
How did Stella get her groove back? Maximal insertion.
It's basically the plot of the movie.
How did Stella get her groove back? Roadhead.
Nice.
Giving or receiving.
How did Stella get her groove back? Pretty Pretty Princess Dress-Up Board Game.
Hello Kitty Island Adventure.
How did Stella get her groove back? Yelling, girl power, and doing a high kick.
You know what would work really good for this one? Alter Boys.
Ooh. How did Stella get her groove back? Deregulating the mortgage market.
Cool.
Okay. I'm going with yelling girl power and doing a high kick.
Game's over, bitches!
Stan wins.
Who had Pretty Pretty Princess?
And
I would have voted.
I also was going to play Freeing Willy.
Freeing Willy, yeah. Nice.
Or Crippling Debt, that would have helped.
Who played Bullshit?
That was good.
All right. Steph, it should work just fine on a Mac. We haven't had any issues with Mac using before.
Yeah, we have. Yeah.
Get a real computer then, you
iPads,
poor.
No. Grab the Hitbox app off the iTunes store, and it'll work so much better.
You can take it down to
please
zero.
Do it.
Can you? Here.
I don't give a shit
Or go to hitbox.tv/rent.
Yeah, that seems to
That works for my phone and all that business.
Yeah, just try
that. So hitbox.tv/retrorama should work for you, too.
Yes.
Hitbox.
Now we're going to fit all these back in.
Go back. Hitbox.tv/retrorama.
He's got this extra box.
Well, it's the lid, basically.
This is fucking fun, guys.
Yeah, it is.
So close. Yeah, you had eight
so far.
Super
Rome,
but it's going.
I had
close
six
eight?
So far. Had eight. No. I had eight, now I have none.
Well, you can't take any of those away.
Oh, Andy.
Andy.
He's down to -1 loco now.
Pretty much.
I want to see Andy
on
three.
On the floor.
I mean, I know it would be ridiculous. 52
card pickup.
See what?
There's more than 52
Andy
there.
Andy on three, four records. I mean, one was ridiculous.
Put all the black ones
in
four
this like the box.
Nine out of ten doctors recommend four to five locos for Andy.
Shit. God, yeah, one was enough of that shit.
Do you think we've got enough payback on your upstairs neighbor? Or do you think...
No.
She's
no.
Crazy.
You're like, we need to dance on the ceiling like Lionel Richie
well,
up in this
we're
bench.
Behind
dancing
a couple
on
dance
the
parties
ceiling.
From right here.
Hello.
Oops.
Is it me you're looking for?
She's blind. She doesn't know who you are. She can't tell. She's blind, you asshole.
But she made a nice bust of you.
Thank you, asshole.
So that, there's a card in here that says Arnold Schwarzenegger. That would have been good for the... There's. Oh, no, that was your trivia.
Conan the Star Destroyer.
That was good. Yeah,
that was good.
Awesome.
Where does daylight savings go? Is it now?
These are all the...
We're now we're back now.
Women's suffrage.
I think it's at 2 o'clock, isn't it? Isn't
hey,
2
hey,
is
Bo,
supposed to officially
Bo. We have to think about the time-traveling switch.
Yes.
What time is it?
It's
12:35
yeah.
right now.
So 1 o'clock?
We got a bunch
or
of people. 2 o'clock.
Is it 1 or 2?
I think it's 2 that it's officially supposed to be.
I think you're right.
Yeah. Okay.
So an hour and a half.
2 of the clock.
We
got to
get the switch out.
Right back there.
Get the lever.
Are all the black cards up?
I don't know.
All the white cards?
Where are all the white cards at?
Right here.
Where are the white women at? We're trying to keep them separated.
We are. Literally, we are. We are practicing segregation, children.
Come out and play.
Segregation is fun. You can do it with your friends.
You and Don, you both got it
right
on time.
Right.
Feel like
hey,
just take everything
at the
look at Sean's
eyes
separated. Just look at him.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Playing this
cock. Oh shit!
Playing this cock. Does anybody remember that song? I think it's "Love Is on the Way" by Saigon.
Yes.
Yeah.
I learned how to play that on guitar to impress chicks, and
Saigon
it was hard as fuck.
Is awesome.
It was hard as fuck.
Was that a nationally?
But pretty too.
Was that nationally? Did that chart nationally?
That was the only song I ever saw them on TV with.
How does it go?
Love Saigon Kid? Song. Come on.
Well, Dana played on guitar for a bit.
Oh, no. Dude, he stretched a single chord like that. I could not do
free
that.
Tonight.
That's right. That's exactly right.
Love is on the way. Oh, they still play at work on our music.
Yeah, really? And they looked like extreme too.
Your
like they looked just like neutron butt cone and all that.
Oh, did you just say I can see it in your thighs?
Yeah. So
I turn every song at work into the dirtiest one. They play that. They play that. Let me tell you about the birds and the bees song, and I'm always back there just yelling real loud. You can yell where we are.
Let me tell you about.
And I'm always like,
when I suck it in.
Well, you tell me, when I stick it in your big brown eye, I just committed sodomy. Yeah, like just trying to.
They look so lame.
Yeah, that song was hard as shit. You had those strings
from
like 8
that.
To 6 to 4 to 2 or something.
8 to 6 to 4 to 2. You got that, Sean?
Oh, I do.
You know what? You're,
then you had to like go down like, and then you had to like immediately go.
They should have puppy shirts on. Matter of fact, he does.
Those bitches.
Later
just fucking with
a bunch of fucks. Did you
learn
it on the high school team and try to get a lot of... I didn't learn it to get a lot of pee on your D.
To get a little pee on your D.
I knew that wasn't gonna work.
Okay.
It's gonna take more than that.
Padawans on my.
It was gonna take a bigger, blacker dick.
Dooku's, right?
Should we pull this up?
We can.
What is that?
Oh, is that
Chuck
Klosterman's
hypotheticals?
22. Yeah, let's do some of the conversation starters.
I'm gonna get an ice cream cone though.
Anybody
so we already went over this one.
Okay.
We'll use this as a jumping off point.
I bet Dan probably could weigh in on that one.
The super gorilla. Alright, ready?
Alright, let's do this.
This is called the Super Gorilla.
Patrick Ewing, you mean?
Genetic engineers at Johns Hopkins University announced that they have developed a so-called Super Gorilla.
Okay.
Though the animal cannot speak, it has a sign language lexicon of more than 12,000 words, an IQ of nearly 85, and, most notable, a vague sense of self-awareness.
That's way more than me.
Oddly, the creature, who weighs 700 pounds, becomes fascinated by football. The gorilla aspires to play the game at its highest level and quickly develops the rudimentary skills of a defensive end. ESPN analyst Tom Jackson speculates that this gorilla would be borderline unblockable and would likely average 6 sacks per game, although Jackson concedes that the beast might be susceptible to counters and misdirection plays. Meanwhile, the gorilla has made it clear that he would never intentionally injure any opponents.
This is so intense.
You are the commissioner of the NFL. Would you allow this gorilla to sign with the Oakland Raiders?
Oh, Raiders. Right. So I'm to give a yes or no answer and then elaborate on that?
Let's talk about it. Why do you think he should or should not be able to sign with the Oakland Raiders?
I think he should. Yeah, I think he should too.
Definitely.
Okay, next question.
I'll tell you why.
Oh, that's it.
I'll give you my reasoning.
Because you're supposed to justify.
I think part of my reasoning is I think because children actually need a football player role model to look up to.
Well, of course.
And I think a gorilla is probably better than most of the other
players. He's not
going to
be taking
really.
His wife and punching her in an elevator or anything like that.
Or trying
know?
To
so
sell
he's already a better role model than most of the fucking NFL.
True.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's going to not try to sell a kilo of cocaine.
And you want to put him down, you tranquilize his ass, take him off the field, he's fine.
Right.
Yeah. Unless Faye Ray is in the audience, you got nothing to worry about.
Right. It'd probably be good for Leah because that whole thing about concussions would go out.
Well, the second a human gets hurt, though, they're going to have to want to put it down or something.
Little known fact, Faye Ray, huge Oakland Raiders fan.
Yeah, exactly.
We're getting into the LKS.
Let's do another random one.
All right. Anybody else want to chime in on the Super Gorilla?
The conundrum is Super Gorilla Raiders, not like just any other team.
Is that a conundrum or is it just a natural fact of life?
What?
The Super Gorilla.
Well, if you put him in Raiders, then
Sebastian
Janikowski
says hell yes.
Somebody can sit next to and not
thank
feel
you.
Self-conscious.
There's always
Tommy,
that.
Tommy's on it.
It's always that
hell zombie. Yes, you like to see it rip players' heads off.
And I think everybody on some level kind of secretly wants to.
But he has expressed.
But I would make out the super gorilla. I mean, why not?
He has expressed that he would not intentionally injure another player.
Well, maybe by accident. He doesn't know his own strength. You know? He's got retard strength.
Well, I would also submit that if he's saying that before
shit.
The game,
oh, okay.
You never know what you're going
to
do in the
what
game.
What do you have to say about retard strength?
Because one time I tried to cross-check somebody
I'm
in the face.
Who will masterminding?
Retard
strength. Raiders still need a gorilla to sense. Bullshit. Oh,
yeah.
Tommy.
Donkey Kong
Tommy
suit.
Feels strongly about it. So, yeah.
Ape shit. I'm thinking that.
Huh. Mike, you want to weigh in on this? Super gorilla. Playing in the NFL. You're the commissioner. Would you
my
let
brain's
him?
Not working. I mean, an ice cream cone at like 1 in the morning.
All right, here's another card. Here's another card. I want to hear
we're
more of these cards.
Look, I want the most like genetically mutated, like super mutant, fucking robotic, cybernetic, fucking everything in any sports arena because it would be awesome.
So battle bots,
super,
yes,
super
okay.
Real battle bots.
Leonard, they tried that in baseball.
But I mean, scary.
Barry Bonds didn't work out.
Yeah, Barry Bonds didn't work out.
Super
Barry
gorilla
Bonds
in baseball,
closest.
They didn't work.
Yes.
Hit a lot of home runs. What does Albert Pujols do? Mike.
Lots of coke.
What is Albert Pujols?
He hit a home run.
I've been waiting for that.
I hit a home run.
Baseball been very, very good.
Yeah, yeah. See, Tommy brings up a good point. It wouldn't just sometimes be accidental. You could also call it a penalty. You know? Like, you have to go one-on-one with the fucking gorilla if you have, like, an egregious foul.
You guys
or something.
Are way over the
accidentals with the same.
That's what these are for.
It's an
next
card. Next card. Next card. Let's do it. What you got?
Oh, shit. Don't get
death
God damn it.
Babe.
You got thrown into the weird-looking sucker. Vagina.
What is that thing? Like a
flower? Stop talking about my vagina.
My vagina this, my
vagina
that.
Your vagina, the crotchinator's vagina? What?
No, Paul. I
Sue
love
is
him.
The
Paul.
All right, what's the next card? What do we got? The Mind Killer?
The Mind Killer.
This? What we're doing now?
Fear of the Mind Killer. Am I not right?
God damn it.
You become friends with a charismatic Spanish insurance salesman who claims to be a mystic. At first you think he is just an interesting weirdo, but then a mutual acquaintance mysteriously dies in his sleep, and your Spanish friend tells you, "I killed that guy. I killed him with my mind." You find this disturbing and inappropriate, but you decide to let it go. 2 weeks later, an unpopular local politician dies in his sleep. "I killed that man too," says your Spanish friend. "I killed him with my mind."
Says your Spanish friend.
This is annoying and tasteless, but once again, you let it go. The very next day, the Spanish insurance salesman calls you on the telephone and says, "Check the newspaper and see what I did with my mind. It's in the entertainment section." When you open the newspaper, you see an obituary for singer-songwriter Tori Amos.
Oh, God.
The article says she mysteriously died the night before. Technically, this proves nothing, but you nonetheless confront your Spanish friend and tell him that you've grown tired of all of the hypothetical mind murdering and that you no longer want to be his friend. "Don't you dare shut me out of your life," he says. "You're my best friend. You must remain in my life. I'm not sure what I would do if you ever betrayed me." Do you remain friends with this possibly delusional, possibly dangerous Spaniard?
Is all that on that
you have,
card?
Yes. You have no physical proof that he can actually kill people with his mind.
Here's my point. You mentioned Tori Amos, and she had a pig suckling on her tit.
She did.
Yes, she
okay.
did.
That's the only
so,
question.
She deserved
to remain friends with him?
Yes.
Well,
no.
Just have him call this next target out.
This possibly delusional, possibly dangerous Spaniard.
No.
Bo, that's why I'm friends with
I
you.
I would still be
but
friends.
You have no physical proof
I mean,
that he can actually
Spaniard.
Kill people with his mind, Andy.
Well, Brian can kill people with his mind.
Well,
and you love Tori Amos.
Do I?
You love the pig suckling on the tip, right?
Who doesn't, right?
Well, yeah.
Bad.
That's what
Dan,
I do.
I was balls deep in a squealing hog once.
Exactly.
Would you remain friends with this possibly?
I would, because he's entertaining as fuck.
Yes.
I'd be like, all right, call out your next target. And
talk
then we'll just make a ton of money. We'll get in somebody's insurance,
hey,
you know, and in their will.
So
you
wanna
mind murder them.
Okay. So
mind
you become
them.
A possible hitman by proxy.
Yes. That way, they can't prove a fucking thing, no matter what. If you even try to pin it on him, they're going to think you're crazy. He says he kills people with his mind, they're going to think he's crazy. But it ever falls apart, he's going to kill you. If he does have that capability.
God damn
okay, I'm
it.
Sorry, this is an episode of The X-Files. Fuck it.
Yeah.
What do you think, Mike?
Keep him around for entertainment value.
If you need a Spaniard in your friend collection, maybe. If you don't.
In your multicultural
yeah,
house.
Yeah. You never know.
Huh. Brian?
You're
going
to need somebody to
trade. You
want to
weigh in
on
those
seeds? I'd stay friends with him, but I wouldn't be happy about it.
But now, would it be because you would you're afraid he might kill you in his sleep?
Yeah, absolutely.
In your
see, there's two. There's
didn't
two.
Say you had to be good
friends,
things,
right?
You
either
be
friends or you either approach
this
him.
This is so.
I would
never say
you would.
Oh,
thank God.
No, hell no.
He's conversations. So you just wear a tinfoil cap. Well, you can approach him.
You
you're either skeptical,
God,
you don't
dude.
Think he can do it at all, or you're like me, afraid of dying, and so you do anything to placate.
You're
him.
Afraid of dying.
Whether
yes.
or not you can prove it, it happened. And he's been flaunting the fact that he could.
It's never going to happen. You're going to live forever.
Yeah, right. He could just be reading the paper
you're
earlier
die.
In the morning
what are you
and
talking
saying,
about?
Yeah, I'm
okay.
murdered that person.
Okay, here's another question.
I'm never
going to
die. What
are
you talking about?
Do you think he is actually capable of this?
I hope.
Killing with
you
money.
Hope,
that'd
because
be cool.
it would make you money. Because
then, no, because then I could also learn his technique.
I would kill people with my mind, but only,
could
you
be
know...
his apprentice?
Assholes.
His apprentice
yeah.
mind
yeah. Mind.
So we've got in for the money, you've got in for justice, in for cowardice, in for cowardice.
We covered all the bases.
Completely neutral on the whole count.
I'm looking at all the people in the room, and I would not kill them with my mind. No.
Maybe
we're
somebody
good.
Else, though.
No, just on principle.
Maybe the next person
no, just on
a
principle.
Pig.
So, you're the only one who actually answered no.
Which is weird.
Maybe.
Well,
you can use those powers for good, too, because what if Super Gorilla is killing somebody on the field, and they can't track
and
him fast enough? You can mind murder the ape.
I'm going to go take a nap and kill
no,
Super Gorilla.
Hold on, because I take the legal aspect of this, because just because you don't have any proof against it, doesn't mean you don't have information that could help the case. Especially if your friend just says, hey, oh no, he didn't, did he?
If you turn him in, he may mind
you. I mean, we're talking about a real world situation where this guy says that he can kill people in his sleep. It's not normal that
people
can kill in
their
sleep.
He said that he can kill that person. Taylor Swift or whoever the hell it was.
Tori Amos, Taylor Swift.
Same thing.
I would
he said he killed her, yes.
He said that he killed her.
But he's saying this after you
find out. So, by law, you are an accomplice if you do not report that.
Not really.
So if you remain friends with this person, yes, you are.
No,
you are because
the point.
Unless that person is never questioned.
No. Wait. If you have good friends, they would never turn you in to the point.
That's
I've
the
read
way the
your
question comes. See, that's
but,
where the question
wait,
comes
not
in.
The point. No, well, all of you.
That's the question,
sorry.
Though. Because
but,
if you don't rat the person out, you remain
you.
Friends with them,
but
you are from that point forward an accomplice
no,
in that
crime.
But think about it.
You are complicit in a potential crime.
Think about this.
But there is no legality.
He claimed he murdered somebody with his mind. How are you going to go to the
cops
and say that?
Correct.
Exactly.
But you're still withholding evidence.
There's no evidence.
As inadmissible as it is.
Evidence.
No, listen.
Tori Amos died mysteriously the night before.
No, but somebody saying that they admit to murdering somebody.
Mind.
Is evidence.
No, it's not.
Is
it no,
admission of guilt?
It's not
you
evidence.
Walk into a, you walk
Quarantine
into a police station.
In LA.
No.
Spaniard is my
friend
here.
You walk into
Illinois.
A police station and say, I just robbed a bank. They're not going to say, no, you didn't. Where's the evidence? They're going to fucking arrest you.
No, wait.
I think these cards are actually awesome.
They will arrest you, yeah. Until there is evidence.
I will kill the Tori Amos and take the fucking rap for it.
So my point
hey,
is,
hey,
done.
Mike's got
We have to get. It's over. We have to get it's Matt's over. Girlfriend.
I killed Tori Amos.
Assault.
Fucking suckled her pig. Whatever.
What is she doing?
Damn. Done.
Point being, you will still be held until they do further investigation.
What the fuck?
Oh no.
Should you have been told? Oh yeah, he told me that.
Right.
Two, three. Whatever.
Let's play this out. Your friend Spaniard tells you he murdered Tori Amos in his sleep.
Exactly.
You go to the cops. My friend murdered Tori Amos in his sleep.
But you wouldn't go to the cops, regardless of if you're going to be friends with them or not. That's
why not?
No.
Well, if you said.
Wait, it's me. I am admitting to the cops I killed fucking Tori Amos.
Tori's
and
cool.
With my mind.
Not the Tommy interviewed Tori Amos before.
Hey, Tori's cool.
And the cops would be like, "Oh, you're the crazy bitch." Yeah. Okay, you're good.
No, no. I mean, if it's a question of
if
legality,
you admit to a
you
murder,
would have gone to police.
Oh, lie.
And eventually, they would have worked it out and said. You are batshit.
Jimmy
Smith's on TV.
Yes, but that is the legal process. That is the legal process.
Not that he was batshit. The fact that Tori Amos is fucking batshit.
Yeah, but the legal process dictates.
She is crazy.
Look, the legal process is moot.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Because there is no
she's a very talented
forensic
talented
testing
exactly.
That's going to link you back to any
Correct.
No, you go to the cops and you say, "Hey, I think this Spaniard mind murdered somebody."
You
they're gonna
say
laugh
it like
at you.
That,
right.
Well, how do you say that?
Or
before,
you,
I think he's
friend.
Telekinetic and he murdered somebody in their sleep last night.
Let's say they take him seriously. They say, "Okay, we've been waiting for a case like this,
yeah.
Right?
We have technology,
right?
That we can peer into
your brain."
I realize
this isn't the question.
Well.
But that's the level that I go to. So no, I wouldn't want to be friends with that person. And if I was ever questioned, then I would have to say, yeah, they told me that they killed them. Not that I would ever be questioned.
That's
but
where
that's
you go wrong.
You would not be an accomplice if you were like,
so,
yeah,
so you,
they
so
told me they've mind-murdered somebody. I did not take that seriously.
So. That's exactly
so,
what
so perhaps it's less of a legal question, more of a moral question?
Correct.
I'd say
and
that
morally,
so
I'm not going to be friends
hey,
with somebody who says, I kill people with my brain,
been a little
and
Andy,
then they say that they killed a celebrity.
Andy, if they
you're
were to say, hey, if they were to say the night before, hey, I'm going to kill Tori Amos tonight in her sleep. She's going to have an aneurysm.
And then the next
it'll
morning,
be in the paper.
Right.
Yeah, there's some legitimacy, maybe.
Okay.
Unless it was like, oh, she's going to get
still,
shot.
You
by
all
head.
Would
well,
still be friends with somebody
fun.
Who says, oh, yeah, I killed her.
Yeah, I would still be friends with them.
Really
until
good.
I
maybe
found
he's in a death
oh,
I would still be friends until I found the right opportunity to rat those fuckers out and not die.
I'm sorry.
I just think it's interesting. I would ask Sean, but he's in gross.
Right?
It's okay.
Right?
I just think it's interesting that you're the
although
only one who would not be friends with him.
Right?
Like, cowardice.
You
want to
be friends with a psycho?
Financial gain.
I need a Spaniard.
Yeah, Michael needs his
diversification.
Cool.
Okay, yeah, so that was a good one. Well, we got a lot of shouting.
She would be cool with that, right?
Maybe, I don't know. See, here's the thing. Wait, before you go on to the next thing.
Okay.
This is the funny thing. Instead of saying, instead of looking at it from the perspective of, like, real world, alright, in real life,
oh, dick, goddammit!
I would be... I'm a skeptic, and I would be like, I don't believe this guy has mind powers. But we all played this through as if he did have mind powers.
Of course.
That's the way we all played it through, rather
and
than
that's why
just
I jumped
skeptical.
To the...
Okay, yeah.
The legality of it. Because should they find
seriously.
Any crazy way to connect your friend, and you knew about it, I think there's a legal connection in there of you being an accomplice if you knew about it. And
all
didn't say anything.
All right, first of all...
Assuming they can
you
burn
say,
that
I'm
a
rational person. I don't believe these powers existed. Yes, he told me that. I thought
but
he
you're
was,
still
that,
afraid of them.
He was Cloud Cuckoo.
Then why are
no,
you
I'm
still afraid of
him? I'm afraid of him because somebody who believes they have powers like that
right.
is not...
Balance.
Yes.
Down.
Now,
yeah.
I will even take it a step further and
next
say,
thing
if you
know,
got to that point and you were
parking
labeled as an accomplice, you could use the excuse of, is anybody really going to believe that?
Shit,
and you'd probably
know.
Get off. You'd probably
Leonard
get off.
Leonard is scaring me. I'm going to go sit by you. He's like, nice to meet you.
Remember Dinner for Schmucks? The one guy who had the mind powers over Steve Carell. It was Zach Galifianakis. Anybody see that movie?
No.
It's kind of funny, charming in a weird way, but yeah, Dinner, they basically these high, you know, big old corporate suit guys, like, basically invite the dumbest idiot they know. and invite them to dinner, and they just basically embarrass the shit out.
So was that a Marx Brothers premise?
Huh?
Was that a premise of a Marx Brothers?
It probably was, actually. Yeah, as a matter of fact, it was. Yeah. It was an old Marx Brothers movie, I think. But they had,
God damn it.
Was it Paul Rudd was the main guy, and Steve Carell was his idiot? And then, who's the main German guy? Was one of the guys from Little Britain.
Zach Galifianakis.
Yeah, he was in it too.
Huh?
You good?
I'm good. I just think it's funny because like
either way, he's got mind
in real life, I would assume that he, this guy.
It's not that you're afraid of his ability to kill you with his mind. You're afraid of his ability to kill you with his hand in some other way.
Yes. Yes.
Right.
Wait.
Well, I'm moving over here.
Sith.
He obviously knows Taekwondo or something.
Seems one would have to speak up that it's the Spanish guy thought he would kill with his mind and admitted as such. Huh.
He would have to call it.
Well, the sad part is
like,
that
say,
I thought
hey,
I was
this person's going to die right now.
Damn.
While you're
every
standing right next to
choice,
them.
So if
like,
anybody who.
Like,
choose life.
Yeah,
no, anybody
I
who spoke up
sad.
On something
I mean,
like that, though, would automatically be branded an idiot.
Yeah.
Or, you know, crazy.
Was,
crazy
but be institutionalized. You won't get your Pepsi.
No,
I try to do everything I can for anybody. That's fucking stupid. I try to be the Sith, but I can't.
But in reality, it's not admitting to a crime when it's not even feasible that he could do that.
Well, it's and admitting to a crime isn't
weird.
Isn't the same as being convicted of a crime.
So, Andy's saying he wants to cut ties with this guy because of being an accomplice in his mind killing?
Yeah.
I could admit to the Lindbergh baby kidnapping and that doesn't legitimize it.
Cut your ties, don't go to prison. Don't do it. Get the fuck away.
No, because he'll kill you next.
That's
he'll be
fine.
The next one.
That's fine. As long as he doesn't go to prison, I'm okay with it.
But him. I'm just saying, like, Andy, alright, if Andy wants to cut ties for being an accomplice or whatever, isn't he essentially admitting to his belief in the killing power of this dude's mind?
But he's also preaching out to the fact that he doesn't want to do it and that he'd like to be a better
person.
I'm
just saying Andy's victim number four. That's what I'm saying. This dude's going to mind kill this dude. He's going to mind rape him and mind kill him.
If you cut ties, you're next.
Well, if he comes against me, I'll teach him.
It's a lesson. I'll show him what's what.
I will scare the shit out of that motherfucker. He has no idea.
Dude, he got too heated over
maybe. Well, that's what it's supposed to do, man.
Yeah. It's supposed to start a conversation.
Yeah.
As much as most people think that I'm actually evil at heart, I'm not.
Not amused. We got it.
Every chance I get, I'm.
Maybe your Spanish friend is speaking Spanish, but you don't know what he's saying.
Yeah. But he's translating it because he puts it directly in your mind.
Better than I think that most people think that I am. It's weird.
I just like how it's so specific.
I don't know why.
The guy is Spanish.
Yeah, I don't know.
He killed Tori Amos.
Yeah, it's weird.
Wait, she's dead?
Well,
in this scenario, yes.
Oh, I wouldn't.
Choked on a suckled pig.
I wouldn't be friends with him. He's from the Iberian Peninsula. Who cares?
Should we move on to number
three?
The fact that his mind powers is new.
I just wouldn't make any friends with the Spanish.
I'm just watching a little bit.
From what I can tell, you have mind powers. I've seen the trivia you bring
same
up.
Same shit. Tiles on the spaceship.
God damn.
Really?
Yeah.
So when you enter orbit,
you'll
burn up.
Your ring will just. That's what I said. I told Carol, like, I can survive re-entry.
I mean, if you
want to
go to market on
the
highbrow fucking trivia, I'm not kidding. Highbrow trivia, you've got the shit fucking cornered. No fucking joke.
I got it.
He's mind humping me right now.
I'm not even trying. I mean, seriously.
He's mind rim jawing you.
Oh,
rusty trombone action.
Jesus.
I mean, if you want your salad, Dawes.
Alright, what's the next one?
It's going to punch a dirt star later. Yeah.
Hit me with your card.
Okay.
Well, look,
okay,
you agree.
Here we go.
Hey.
You accept.
You agree.
Was pretty fucking good.
This man.
Can read again.
No, I agree with you entirely.
Genius at trivia.
Genius.
All right, tell your story.
Upgrade.
Shut the fuck up. Oh,
no, 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 his pajama pants.
All right, gnome killer.
Do it.
I use my mind.
He's got his jammy jams on.
Yeah, couple of wavy lines. Couple of wavy lines.
What's it called? The moon fight? Fight?
The moon fight.
All right,
moon
are we ready
fight.
For this?
What are we doing?
Yes. The super the gorilla versus fight. The mind killer.
Just
who wins?
Skip shit. God,
the moon fight, cool. Tommy. Ready?
Without the story,
super
it's
gorilla.
Just like, it's a
total stranger picks a fight with you in a bar. This stranger is exactly your size and weight. You have done nothing to this individual to warrant such animosity, but the stranger really wants to fight you. Do you... You want to keep reading over question? This stranger really wants to fight you. And to make matters weirder, this stranger wants to fight you on the moon. And this is somehow possible.
Okay.
You and the stranger will be transported to the surface of the moon, outfitted in ultra-thin and very comfortable spacesuits, and rigged with lightweight oxygen tanks. You will then be expected to fight for 10 three-minute rounds. You can't use weapons. There are no rules, and you cannot quit unless
Wait,
you or your.
Hold on. You can't use weapons is a fucking rule. Pick up a rock and smash his dome.
Can I finish the goddamn question?
Sorry.
Here we go.
You will then be expected to fight for 10 three-minute rounds. You can't use weapons. There are no rules, except for the no weapons. And you cannot quit unless you or your opponent are knocked unconscious. Do you accept this challenge? And if yes, what is your moon fighting strategy?
Oh my god.
I would knock him the fuck out and buy him drinks till he's drunk as a shit. Alright.
How is he gonna drink this stuff when he's knocked out on the moon?
No, I would knock him the fuck out.
Okay.
The second he wakes up, we're just gonna have drinks at the bar.
So you bro down with
him. After you have sex,
maybe.
Obviously.
Bro down with
you. You bro
yes.
down with
him. Fuck yeah.
Okay.
It's not really a bro down.
It's a bro down, ho down. I get it. We all know what a bro down, ho down is.
I would accept the fact that if.
Is it a fight to the death, though? Didn't say.
Yeah, it's just that unconsciousness, right?
Right.
The stream is more stable with chrome on Mac.
You could punch the shit out of me, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, either way. I punch the shit out of him, he punches the shit out of me, whatever.
It doesn't matter.
Well, you're in low ground.
So your strategy here is, first of all, you accept the challenge.
Oh, sure.
And your strategy is to just slugfest.
Well, not to be a dick, but, you know, just...
Just gotta find a...
Wins, whatever.
Find an air farm with Crushinator nearby.
No, Ma, I love him. Brian, what do you think? Yeah, you're very... Yeah, I can see the gears turning slowly.
No,
but
I've done this before in real life.
I've got
a video
on the moon.
Of it.
Okay. Well, not on the moon, mind you.
Not on the moon,
okay.
But I have video of this in real life on Earth.
Okay. Brian, do you accept this challenge? And if yes, what is your strategy?
Well, all right. Do you know more, like on Comedy Bang Bang, do you know more than what... Can I ask you questions?
No.
Yes.
Real life? No. Bullshit.
Yes.
No.
I am the arbiter of this question.
Fuck you. No.
Well, no. What are your questions?
Just to clarify.
No favorites.
Because of my aforementioned fear of death.
I'll allow it. But watch yourself,
counselor. You just fight to the unconsciousness, not
exactly.
to the death.
That's what it says.
Stupid.
Assuming if death happens, which could be very probable, being on the moon.
That's what I was going to ask.
Does he teleport you immediately?
Oxygen, atmosphere, you're good.
You cannot
die.
Unless you or your opponent are knocked unconscious. You fight to unconsciousness.
Minimum is unconscious.
Well, I have
probably
right.
still
right.
die.
But the 3 10-minute rounds?
It's like 10
3-minute.
10
3-minute.
You're going to be fighting for 30 minutes.
One of you is going to get KO'd.
Yeah, exactly.
No. Or until somebody is knocked out.
And you're bouncing around, you know, less gravity,
right.
You're bouncing around. Man,
right.
I was probably exhausted.
Your
before.
Best choice is 2 minutes. Fuck it, I'm going to lose and just hang out with this motherfucker and have a good time.
You're going to risk being knocked out.
Yeah, who cares?
Brian cares, I think.
I care.
There's a fear
fact,
of dying.
I don't know if I would accept
what if you
challenge.
Do? What if you do get a rip in the suit or a crack in your helmet? You're going to fucking
dying.
Die.
No.
All
no,
the
no.
liquid in your body
He's
would
not,
form
you're
a ball
dying.
And you'd implode.
Imagine all of this. What is
oh my god,
it? All
this is terrible.
All the atoms in your body exploding at the speed of light.
Shut up.
This is
not Ghostbusters.
That's a big Twinkie.
He picks a fight with you and says, on the moon. You, me, on the moon.
Okay.
Sigourney Weaver, like, circa, like, early 80s. Right?
Well, still scary.
But well, then I would say...
Still scary, but
no.
Yes.
You refuse this challenge.
My answer is no as well.
No.
My answer is no as well.
Okay. Again, he
why
would
you
be viewed as crazy
because
and he would just laugh at
it. I can't come up with a viable strategy not knowing how he's going to fight.
Here's an easy one.
10 3-minute rounds for 30 minutes.
I would do it.
What the fuck? Why are you
so does that apply
right.
to every situation
I
in which you might
be
in
worth
a little less than a
physical
I
don't always do.
Because you never know
yeah.
how the other person is going to fight.
Of course. Of course.
What the hell?
I don't think it's so
well,
much
why
about
is it different here?
Because of the 30 minutes and...
Well, it's 30 minutes or unconsciousness, which whatever comes first.
Oh, wait, he's going to knock
two
us
hits
out.
Two hits,
or you
knock
him
in the moon.
Wait, you're also in zero gravity. You're in zero
minute,
gravity, so
you're
it's
not
like you're in a UFC
for
ring.
For the
you're going
to
get tired real fucking
quick.
That's true. That's if I knock him out.
Right.
But I would have to come up with, yeah, I would have to come up with something that
question, man.
Right. And I question. What would the strategy be? What would the strategy be?
I don't have
it. Hang on. It might be worth... risking death to hang out on the fucking moon. Tommy!
That's true.
Just, you know, cutting to the quick there.
Doing everything right.
Okay.
I don't think right.
My question.
Who?
Between rounds, are there ring girls in green Martian suits?
Oh my god.
To drop out of them.
We would fake fight and just make out with them later.
There we
right?
go. Yes.
Why don't you drop out of that green Martian suit and show me that big fat ass?
Hell yes.
Say word.
What?
Word.
Three tits.
What?
Total recall tits.
No.
Exactly.
Possibilities.
There are no ring girls.
There are no. But.
Okay.
What? No.
No well, no. There
girls?
Are no Martian ringer.
Okay.
Girls. There are
Venetian
ringers.
We still have three tits.
They,
or no.
They have three breasts.
Oh, we're good.
They're
we're
on.
Good.
They're,
I'm for
they're
that.
On
so
their right ankle.
Down.
Okay.
And they,
they
resemble
are.
The Crushinator. Okay. It's an organic Crushinator,
wow.
is what I'm trying to say. With tits on their ankles.
Still good.
Ankle?
Three on each ankle?
So you're not discerning.
You know,
finally, because
when their ankles are up on my ears, I can play with the tits.
Look.
Full-size tits or proportionate tits to the size of their ankles? Like,
tall, short,
oh,
robotic,
organic,
flapjack
tits.
Kathy Bates. Think Kathy Bates.
They're
dragging
on the ground behind
me. I'm out.
Where are
I asked the right question, man.
Pants.
I'm glad I asked before I made my decision.
See that Irish champion down there?
You would not accept the challenge.
Yeah.
You would look like a pussy in front of everybody in the bar.
Yeah.
Like, but Tommy,
I think
you can go hang out on the fucking moon. You might get your ass knocked out, but who cares?
You're
on
the
fucking
moon.
You would be one of a dozen people
hey,
in this world who had ever been on the goddamn moon.
Where whalers
honestly.
On the moon.
I was thinking.
That whole
moon.
Oh, damn drama, yes. We're whalers on the moon.
We carry
a
harpoon.
This is historically accurate.
Oh, that was nice.
Oh, yours are terrible.
I don't know. I'm thinking about it. Would I like?
Liz, has anything changed for you?
Well, I might do Brian on a strip.
What?
Whoa.
Hell
on the moon. Did you hear about the flapjack tits? Did you hear that part?
Kathy Bates. That's all I'm saying.
Hey, Sharky.
Well, if the flapjack tits
hi,
are yours.
Hi, Shark.
Oh,
man.
He's as perky as ever. I don't know what you're talking
anything
about.
Anything changed for you?
Full support.
Oh, no, right? No, he was.
Fuck it. No, it's not worth my time.
My sports brassiere.
Mike, what do you think?
Fucker.
What was the question?
My
Dan, what do you think?
Yeah.
You're
what
so,
are we talking about?
First off, I would have questions for this guy. I'd be like, first
can
off,
they
how
have...
fucking high are you right now? Second,
very.
How are
he
we getting
very
there?
High
how are we
PCP.
Getting there? Are you going to teleport us with your mind powers? Is he Spanish?
No, you're going to take a space shuttle. Obviously.
About that.
It's only a 30-minute drive.
No.
Thanks to new.
Oh, I forgot. I forgot to elaborate on my answer of not accepting the challenge. I got glaucoma. I got time for this shit.
What's in it for me?
I got time
know.
For this.
Get, have the ability to hang out on the goddamn moon.
If
or
I no, if I knew it was legitimate and I would be on the moon, I would fucking do it in a heartbeat. But if he was just a crazy drunk in my bar, I would be like, no, dude.
Well, no, wait a minute. Is there, if it's
you're
a
retarded.
Crazy drunk on the,
I mean,
on the,
if you can
in your bar,
space race to the moon, sure.
That is that has the ability to fight you on the moon.
Yeah.
Now let's say this. Let's tweak it a little bit and say that. Hold on a second. Let's tweak it a little bit.
Complicating this shit. That's the question.
The answer's no.
Oh,
I'm not gonna fight you. I don't know
you.
You
guys are talking about
blackjack.
Hold on. Let's tweak it a little bit and say that.
Question.
If you fight this man, it's the only way you could get onto the moon. He has the exclusivity rights to the moon.
Let's hypothetically say that for the last 3 weeks I've seen this guy on television fighting people on the fucking moon. Then hell yes, I would go up to the moon. That way it would be legitimate, and I know he would actually not be crazy. Okay? It doesn't make any sense to you? I thought it was pretty straightforward. I don't believe the guy is gonna go to the fucking moon.
Jesus
for
Christ.
One.
The question says you're going to the moon. Stop arguing about whether or not you're fucking going to the moon.
How do I not question
right.
that though?
This is possible. This is the thing.
I will just accept that.
I'll fight
him on the moon then.
Because you get to hang out on the moon.
Yeah,
right?
And if I lose a fight on the moon, I'm like, I'm still on the moon.
You're still on the moon.
And if I win, I'm like, I'm a champion.
Wait,
I'm undefeated on the moon.
Wait. Remember, you're not just fighting on the moon. You're fighting whalers on the moon with harpoons.
Okay, now we're just getting ridiculous.
Yeah, I would do it. Totally do it.
Hell yeah,
Prussian
hitter.
Yeah.
And then
I
guess like Tori Amos up there.
Now you gotta answer
Prussian
what your strategy is.
And Tori Amos.
That's why
Grab
a
rock.
Fighting
this
we
double
team her.
Now, since it's low gravity, we're not gonna tire out as quickly. So there's not gonna be much grappling. It's gonna be a strategy type thing. You're gonna feel each other out a little bit, you know. He's gonna take a swing and I'm dropping his ass down. And then I'm gonna spin him around like in Superman and try to throw his ass off the moon. That's what I would say.
Pretty much.
And then we're going to hang out and it'll be cool.
The
solid strategy.
That you
can
get to the moon is a giant problem. But the assumption that you're automatically going to win, nothing.
That's confidence.
that's just fucking going to happen.
Confidence. That's all it is.
That's it.
Sean, you would never win because you're too obsessed with the Star Wars games.
I would never win because I'm a damn adult and I don't have to fight some crazy fucker.
I mean, it doesn't matter if I got my ass knocked out.
I'm an adult, but I'm still a crazy motherfucker, and you know.
Now, if going to the moon was commonplace,
I'm guessing
yes.
it is.
Well, how would you feel about that, Dan? Like you could go to the moon by yourself tomorrow.
This
guy wants to fight you on the moon.
Let's say I just couldn't afford to go to the moon. I always wanted to go. Yeah, I'd do it.
Okay.
Why not?
Let's say it was super cheap.
I always wanted to go.
Like that we colonized the moon.
Okay, why would I? Yeah, I wouldn't care then. I would go on my own then.
In my DeLorean.
I wouldn't have to fight him. Because that's a risk. I mean, there is a risk involved with that. I mean, he could have a gang of dudes jump you and say, yeah, whatever.
Moon and ice.
So the best argument is just fucking, let's have a good time together. Have a couple of drinks.
I mean, that could be, I guess.
I would hope.
If we're talking about on the moon.
We're not trying to fight people. I'm going to walk the fuck away. I know that you've
been. Let's go to a bar on
too.
The moon and get shit faced. Then we'll fight in the bar.
Yes. We might fight in the bar.
Wait,
right.
Okay.
Shot.
Okay,
are we ready to.
I'll pour it. You're good. Yes.
yes.
Damn, Lynn is down. Down to be the clown, man. She's all, let's keep drinking. Let's do it.
One shot.
Let's go fight on the moon. Let's do it now.
Let's get that other Four Loko.
Really?
Okay, we ready for the next one?
Yeah,
let's go for it.
It's called The Nude Acquaintance.
The Nude Acquaintance.
Oh, God.
Look, I'm sorry, but I'm done with your mom. Seriously.
The Nude Acquaintance.
Oh, God damn it.
Okay.
Oh,
think of a specific friend of yours. Not your best friend, but someone who is A, more than an acquaintance,
yeah,
and B, physically attractive.
Yeah.
One day, while trolling the internet, you accidentally come across three nude photographs of this person reclined on a sofa bed. The pictures were clearly taken several years ago. This is obviously autobiographical for Dan. The pictures were clearly taken several years ago, and it's unclear if the photos were casually posed or taken without the subject's knowledge. Your friend looks comfortable, but he/she is never looking directly into the lens of the camera. The pictures are not labeled, and your friend's name is not listed anywhere on the site. But you're certain that this is the same person you know.
So this is on a site, Ben.
Yes, you're certain that this is the same person you know.
I found an ex-girlfriend.
What do you do with this information, and do you tell him?
No.
Depends.
What do you do with it?
It depends on the friend for me.
Yeah, well, if it's somebody I really don't, I don't care what their reaction would be, I wouldn't care.
Right.
Like, oh my God, I'll never guess what I found him. But if it was somebody, I liked, and you know, I wouldn't care, because the internet is
somebody
creepy.
You like. You
it depends on how embarrassed about the website
about
you were looking
at.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like if it was somebody I didn't like, I'd probably be like,
hold
man, guess who I saw on the internet.
But what would you do with that? If would you do anything?
No.
No.
Because there could be some really malicious things.
Somebody
knew
the information.
I would not have them incriminated in any way. Like I wouldn't.
Right.
Tell people where it was. I wouldn't tell them anything about it.
Right.
You know, and I'd be like, you know, I don't want them. Like, what if they have a job, and somebody finds out they have those online? And it gets around their job. They're done there.
Yeah, like their high school teacher.
I wouldn't do that to somebody.
Now you can go
even somebody
deeper.
I don't like.
There are websites where, like, it depends. I don't think that was detailed enough to say if this was a site of like. This person uploaded these photos, or these are just a bunch of random photos. Check out these hot photos. That
it's unclear unclear whether or not they were posed or if they were taken without the person's
right the pictures themselves. But I'm saying what they are displayed as from the website. If it's displayed as this user has these photos, or if it's saying these are just a bunch of random photos, check them out. If it was a bunch of random photos and check them out, and they were a good enough friend, I would probably tell my friend and say. Give that to them?
Hey, check this out. I saw your anus.
Right. Like,
I
if it was on one of those campsites.
I saw
your
bleached asshole.
If it was on one of those campsites,
like
one of those
Wesley.
Sex sites of, like, uploading a user's photos,
yeah,
then
right.
I would leave it alone. But if it was random photos and I saw them, like, oh my God, I probably would mention it.
Like,
say,
if it was pictures of sauce, I would show the world.
Oh,
yeah. Oh,
that'd be hilarious.
Oh, God, yeah.
Oh,
just wearing his Chicago Blackhawks hat, just kind of like this on the sofa bed, like, what's up? I'm sauce.
Huh.
Sauce.
Okay.
Sir Sauce the Awesome.
What do you think, Mike?
Are you around?
And possibly hermaphroditic.
Depends on how embarrassed you are about the site that you're looking at to share that information is the
that too.
Oh, okay.
Because that's another
level.
Well,
that's an interesting
you'd be like,
wrinkle.
Hey, I was on pigfuckers.com. I wasn't on pigfuckers.com.
Oh, convenience sauce.
So it's more about your own... making sure you're walling yourself off than protecting somebody else.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so...
I wouldn't want to be the
selfish.
One responsible
selfish
for those photos getting out there at all.
No, it would be different for me.
What do you think?
I don't give a damn about myself.
Okay.
Yeah. Anybody else?
So, you go to pigfuckers.com. You know,
sheepfuckers.com.
Youfuckers.com?
It's squealing hog.
I like crossword puzzles.
You, I
no,
get it.
No.
Necrophilia.
I don't give a damn.
Pyronecrophilic
bestiality.
But
you have described what the photos look like.
No,
I care about
myself.
So,
okay.
I care about my friends.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a little bit more than an acquaintance.
Well, and no matter what side it is,
no matter what
side it is, that has described what the photos are. So even if it's necrophilia or bestiality, those photos are specifically them just posing.
Yes, these photos are very tame.
They're not fucking a horse.
Right.
They're not fucking a horse.
Which is really
okay.
Gross.
So, what do you do with this information? Yeah, you see it. You see pictures of this person. What do you do?
Tell no one.
Tell no one? Not even them?
Never. No one.
Not even the person that...
If it involves them, photos. I might talk to them about him and say, you know... I'm not judging. Just saying, what do you want to know about this?
Right.
Well, yeah.
What do you want to do
about
this?
You know anything about pickfucking stuff?
That opens up another can where why were you on that website to begin with? Then it's like, I'm
right,
the creep
exactly.
for jacking off the internet.
No,
board.
You're not,
okay.
Because your naked photos aren't on the site.
Exactly.
That trumps it no matter what.
Well, they'll still make you feel bad.
No judgment.
Well, of course they will,
because
they'll be feeling vulnerable.
Exactly.
Right.
They'll get defensive.
I think I'm there.
So it depends on the friend. If you know that friend's going to react
my
God,
I'm that way.
Then... But if you think that friend's going to be like, hey,
you
want to see more?
I don't really care if somebody finds out I'm on pickfuckers.org.
Yeah, exactly.
If that's what I'm into.
I don't care. You can do whatever you want. No, I would never say shit about anything. I don't care, and I don't judge.
Huh.
Do whatever you want.
So,
if you enjoy it, I don't give a damn.
How good of a friend would they have to be in order for you to go to them and say, look, I'm really concerned because I saw somebody who looks a lot like you. I'm almost sure
you could certainly
that
be
it's
you.
And they're on this website.
You can be very neutral.
And if it was reversed and it was somebody else, it doesn't matter if I know them or not. I have total respect for...
Could have given it up. I mean...
Like I said,
people doing what they want to do.
Exactly.
Well, but it's not clear whether or not those pictures are.
Doesn't matter. It's not
sensual.
It's not my business. It's not my business. No judgment. You do whatever you want.
Okay. So we got self-preservation.
I don't really.
We got ignorance. Ignorance is bliss, basically.
It's not ignorance. It's
Just like a...
It's respect for whatever you choose to do.
Privacy.
There's a term for that, of like non-interference.
That's not private, though. I mean, it's...
Well,
that's
it is
not
private,
because
I wouldn't say a
private.
Damn word.
I mean, it would be different if you saw them on somebody's phone. This is on the internet. This is publicly displayed.
What?
That's
if
not
I saw them on somebody's phone, no. Because I am not like a... I am not like... No, I would never.
But I don't think it's
right,
nothing.
Right. But yeah, but you happen upon these photographs in a public forum.
It would never happen.
I don't think it's
nosy.
Private anymore once it's in
I'm
the public.
I'm not nosy.
Forum.
I really
but
don't give.
But you really love pigfuckers.org. Like that's where you go.
It's a great
website.
That's
your go-to.
That's not part of the question.
You get a nut off.
That's not part of the question.
That's Tori Amos.
That's not part of the Tori Amos.
The point is that I honestly do not give a damn about what anybody else does. I really don't. I have no interest in anything anybody does.
And did you hear my argument about it's...
If it could potentially damage that
it's
person,
no longer
I would bring it up to them and say,
domain,
hey,
whether or not
look,
they're aware of it.
I don't know if you're aware of this, but...
So you can't...
Or I would tell somebody who's closer to them to tell them. That way I'm exalted.
No. I am honestly...
Because I'm a coward when it comes to that shit.
I honestly don't... No, it has nothing to do with cowardice.
I'm admitting...
But well, it could be seen, I think, both ways.
This is the weird part about me. I really have no interest in anybody's business. I really don't. I really don't give a fuck what you do. I don't care. I don't even want to look at your phone. Nothing. I don't give a fuck what you do.
Okay, so ignorance then. Like, you're not going to pass this information on to anybody.
Hell no.
You will not be concerned.
You will not
be concerned whether or not the person in these pictures
right,
knows that they exist or not.
Go to bed.
You stumble upon them and
the
you move on.
Capital.
Yeah, no, I don't.
And you forget that you saw them, or you don't tell anybody you saw them.
Oh my God, it's so pessimistic.
No, the point is that I wouldn't even look. I don't give a fuck. I really don't have any interest in learning anybody's shit.
So that wouldn't affect you at all if you just were on a porn site and be like, oh my God, I think I know that person. You would just move on.
Yeah. No, honestly, I really, really do not give a shit about what anybody else does.
You wouldn't even go, ha, and then move on.
No.
Okay.
No, honestly, no.
Kind of a neo-libertine.
Very much is.
I'm weird that way. I really, honestly don't care. Only because I hope that other people... Shut the fuck up. I really hope that other people feel the same way.
mean, give me the same respect. I really
that they would see and be like, oh my god, okay, he's doing his thing, and whatever, and move on.
Right. I don't give a fuck about it. I would never do that. It's .gov,
by the way.
Yeah. I would think that...
You know me well enough. I honestly don't give a fuck.
No, what I was going to say is I would hope that attitude is more prevalent than I think. You know, that
and there's one of your examples.
Welcome to BigFucker.org.
There's nothing here. I really don't give a fuck what anybody I don't look at anybody's phones. I'm not like peering and looking at shit. I'm really not curious. Fuck that shit. No.
So no. You never go to pigfuckers.org, even though fucking pigs.
Dan just
in
did.
There
is
right there.
Dan just did. No,
he did.
Literally.
All right. You can show me. I got the show for the night.
There's nothing there.
Virginity Rita.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Brian?
I really don't give a fuck.
I was listening super closely to the question. Does the person have... If you tell the person or whatever, do they have recourse for...
You don't know. You don't know. That's not the question. The question is, do you tell them?
To be more specific, I'm
I think
not
it all
curious.
Depends on your
really
relationship
not.
With that
right, because you have to pick a friend, and you have to understand how you think that person would react should you tell them.
Think about it this way. I wish I had motivation for stuff, but I don't. I am not motivated for anything. And that means finding out
Let's buy it. Let's buy pigfuckers.
A ton of work.
You just buy it.
I just like that it's a non-profit. Bigfuckers.edu.
Oh my god, or GOV.
Sorry.
Oh, you can't buy those.
Yeah, you were saying.
What do I mean is, I have no motivation. I honestly have no motivation to find out anything about anyone. I really don't.
Well, it's not about finding out about somebody. It's about stumbling onto somebody.
But he just
some
said
information.
That he
it's not about finding.
Even so, I have no interest. I don't give a fuck.
Okay, so you
and
stumble
never...
upon pictures of somebody, you know, whether or not, it doesn't matter, move on.
It wouldn't interest me. I don't give a fuck.
Move on.
Seriously. Yeah, yeah.
No, I get it. I get it.
Yeah.
Okay, Brian, what were you saying?
Oh, like if the person had recourse.
You'd have to decide that based on the person you pick in your papers.
But I mean, like, if things live on the internet and their image was taken, copied, or whatever,
right.
is there much of a point of telling them if...
If they didn't want it there, then yes, they can contact the site and they can have it removed. That by law...
Wait. This is a different point. You're saying if there's recourse, if there's some kind of motivation for me to do something? No, I really don't care, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tommy brings up an interesting point. The key part of the question was that it wasn't clear whether or not they knew they were being framed.
And that's the risk you take by telling them or not telling them.
Right. Even if you photograph them, I really don't give a fuck. Do whatever you want. I don't care.
That's awesome.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
So what do you think, Brian?
Piglets.
Well, I guess
it's a judgment call.
I mean, it depends. I guess it,
with the piglets.
Part of it depends on my relationship with the person. I guess.
Right.
That was the beginning of the question.
It's not a best. It's not a best friend. It's a little more than an acquaintance.
So when you have to find a track.
Like I'm trying to picture like somebody at work, say, who I would see 4 days out of the week. You
right.
know, whatever.
Right.
You're not close with them, but you know of
but
them.
You know
right.
them. You have to pick a specific person, because, yeah, that's an easy answer. It's just like, it depends on the person, but you have to pick a person.
That's what it is.
Sausage.edu.
Stop it. Stop
Mike's
making me
loopy.
Laugh, you motherfucker.
I would tell
okay.
my person.
I think I would ask about it.
He would.
You would have a problem.
I wouldn't have a problem. I would ask. To me, the crux of the question is about whether or not the person is there was ambiguity about whether the person is aware.
Correct.
Right. That they are on the internet.
That's why you feel compelled to say something.
Yes.
Yes.
But see, I wouldn't even care. I don't give a damn.
Well, I mean, that's slightly sociopathic of you.
No.
Slightly, yeah. I mean,
well,
it lacks empathy. I mean,
I
only
that.
If you assume that they didn't know.
No,
because
no,
what
I
it
understand.
Sounds like is what you're saying is that you would possibly No, not ignorantly, but you would just...
I'm out.
I can understand the sociopath in me because I really don't
bacon.
Give a damn. There's no empathy. I really don't care.
Right. Just, I think more people would be empathetic to the situation. Like,
but do you agree?
Curious,
with
I think,
you
might
think
be a more appropriate word than empathetic. Curious, I think, might be more of an appropriate word.
No, I would say empathetic. I mean, I would be curious as to whether or not they intended for these photographs to get online. That would be
serious thing to show.
Oh shit! I would be concerned. I would be concerned that they were online without their consent.
And that's you
and
assuming.
That's why
that
I would go to
that.
That's
you assuming that they didn't.
I mean, it
like,
doesn't mean that I
not in the realm of
no. That's not me assuming that they
whatever.
Didn't know. That's
no,
me
really
not knowing whether those, according to the question, not knowing
think
whether they're consensual or not.
That's fine.
So from that, it's a no-brainer that I need to go to this person and say,
I mean,
look,
I don't know
the
you.
Down low, can I talk
you
to you out of room?
That's good.
Here's a site, and, you know, I like fucking pigs, man, but I found...
Man,
I found,
they're the best, aren't they?
I found your photographs on this site. You,
oh my God,
you know, if you know about it, cool. If you don't, that's cool,
them.
Too. I don't really want to know anymore.
I found them
but
on the site.
Just
come
so
on.
You know,
using
after I masturbated several times furiously,
let's not say it's
here
Google.
You go.
Of course, Cosh Johnson.
Of course it would change if it was your mom.
Oh my God. Really?
Piglets
and Diglets.
Did you say Pork
like
Johnson?
I would say something because I feel like what do you got to lose? Either they know about it and are probably cool with it.
Obviously.
Right? Or they don't know about it and they appreciate
And they would appreciate you saying, oh my God.
Or they know about it and are mortified that you found it. In
okay,
which
so
case, you have to go another step in the empathy.
And you still have to
say,
look,
it's okay.
Yeah.
I'm not telling you to go.
I'm fine with that. But either way, I'm in
the
tower.
Right. As long as you own it. I like fucking pigs, man.
Yeah.
As long as you own it, you're in the power position, I guess. But
so both.
But yeah, you could also lord it over them.
Yeah, exactly.
If you,
I have
you
a thumb drive with these
but
images.
But nobody has,
and
nobody
if you
has
want to
said
purchase
that.
It
nobody
from
has
me.
Said, like,
no, fucking
hey, I found pictures of you online. I can circulate them. How about
I'm
you?
Ask this
blow
once he stops talking.
Yeah.
So
you're okay with me being a sociopath?
Oh, here you go.
Well, everybody has those tendencies. It's not, and I'm not name calling. I'm just saying, my inclination is to be concerned about it.
Stop. No name calling. I know that I'm a sociopath.
Okay. I mean, but my inclination doesn't line up with that. And when those things don't line up,
But you know that I love
I kind
people.
Of wonder,
and there's
like,
certain people that are
why it is that you're so adamantly just push it away. Nothing, don't want to know, don't care. Yeah.
Severe anxiety.
Mm, okay.
Paranoia.
Yeah.
But there are certain people that I really get along with.
Piglets with Diglets.
That one's so cracked me up.
Sorry.
All right, are we moving on?
Are we?
By all means.
Because this one's, well, you'll just have fun with this one. Imagine you could go back to the age of five.
So we went
well,
to
it's almost time to pull
a serious
pull.
Number of like
oh
eight
my
nine,
God.
Two, zero,
imagine
so
you can go back to the age of five. And relive the rest of your life, knowing
thank
everything
you.
That you know now.
I don't know. There you go.
You will re-experience your entire adolescence with both the cognitive ability of an adult and the memories of everything you've learned from having lived your life previously. Would you lose your virginity earlier or later than you did the first time around, and by how many years?
Kind of a dumb question.
What if you haven't lost it yet?
Wait a minute.
Well, with two kids, I'm going to ask some questions.
So. Yeah,
now,
me too. With two kids, we're going back to the other question. I'm concerned for you.
I saw some pictures of you on the internet earlier. I lost mine late. I was in high school. I would have done it when I was two.
Sean. No.
What?
I would have done it earlier.
I have to.
But I would have been safe.
Yes, we all think
yeah,
we would have been safe.
I was safe, you know, by staying.
Okay, maybe that wasn't that one.
That one's not that.
Yes, several years. Moving on.
I'm not gonna lie.
Oh my Piglets dear
with
fucking
Diglets.
Lord.
That was good.
Did you say Diglets?
Piglets with Diglets, yeah.
Is it like Chiclets with
Chicklets with dicklets?
Or that Spaniard, he's a spicklet.
Oh, man.
Mind murdered. If I don't wake up tomorrow, he mind murdered me.
And well, if I don't wake up tomorrow,
hypothetical guy. Mind murdered.
Yeah, you were talking about having shots.
I did.
Yes, you did.
Bro him.
Are you out?
Oh man.
This one's weird.
Oh yeah, I'm out.
This one.
Peace out. Yeah, I'm out.
All right.
Did you be back tomorrow?
It's hard to say.
Okay.
I might be, I might not be, I don't know. But evidently I gotta hang out with Reed because I didn't hang out with him enough tonight.
Well, you know, it's just
you.
Fun.
Yeah, that's right. Oh well.
Yo, Bass, shut the fuck up. You can't be tired. You slept like 10 times more than I did.
No, like 2 times more, I think.
You slept.
You got like 4 hours. I think I got maybe 8.
Yeah, you may have slept like 20% more
than
I did.
In the race
to
the bottom,
right.
You are in first place, Lynn.
I've always been in first place.
You're
benign.
Benign. I'm sleeping as fuck.
Alright, I got one more for you guys. This is funny. It should be short.
So, -2.
And Brian, you're going to miss the pulling of the lever in 20 minutes.
It's usually your thing.
Me?
Yeah,
well,
you're the one that
I'll sell one for 20 grand.
Yeah.
Oh,
I can do it. 20
grand?
That's right.
Yeah.
All right.
What about 20 grand?
That's
you meet your soulmate.
20 grand.
Oh, shit.
Mm-hmm.
You meet your soulmate.
Done.
Wait, Brian. Right.
However, there is a catch.
I don't know.
Don't
they're trying to tell me.
We'll see you then.
All right, we'll see you. Take care. It was good to
see
you.
See you, man.
See ya. See ya. See you, Brian. So I don't know if I'm gonna be back. So, I'll see you. Safe trips out.
I'm here till Tuesday. So.
Oh, till Tuesday.
Yeah, I got time.
Voices,
awesome.
Gary.
See
you later.
I'll be pops.
See you, man.
The trivia was fucking awesome.
Okay, thanks.
You meet your soulmate. However, there's a catch. Every 3 years, someone will break both of your soulmates. Collarbones with a crescent wrench, and there's only one way you can stop this from happening.
Wait a minute. Say that last part again.
Every
something
3 years,
about
someone will break one of your
soulmate's shoulder bone with a fucking crescent
collar
wrench.
Collarbones with a crescent wrench,
every
and there's only one way you can stop this from happening.
I saw
every
that.
3 years,
well, I saw that.
Getting
three,
yours
okay.
broken instead.
You must swallow a pill that will make every song you hear for the rest
yeah.
of your life sound as if it's being performed by the band Alice in Chains.
Hell yeah, I would do that.
When you hear Creedence Clearwater Revival on the radio, it will sound to your ears like it's being played by Alice in Chains. If you see Radiohead live, every one of their tunes will sound like it's being covered by Alice in Chains. When you hear a commercial jingle on TV, it will sound like Alice in Chains. If you sing yourself to yourself in the shower, your voice will sound like a deceased Alice in Chains vocalist Layne Staley performing a cappella, but it'll only sound like this to you.
I
would you swallow
that
the pill?
Like,
yeah.
Like,
wait, what?
That'd be fucking awesome, man.
Really?
Bullshit.
I missed. I...
Everything
bullshit.
Sounds like
don't
Alice in Chains
it.
If you take a pill to prevent somebody
oh, yeah,
breaking your
yeah,
collarbone every 3 years.
Great.
Where's the downside? She keeps
if you're a super
intact.
Alice in Chains fan, then the entire pantheon of recorded music becomes Alice in Chains
that's,
doing
the downside.
ABBA.
I would do it for the
time. Alice in Chains. I mean, the
hey,
entire
I do
the
love
entirety
ABBA.
Of recorded
shut
music.
Shut the fuck up. I love ABBA.
But it won't be ABBA. It'll be Layne Staley singing ABBA.
Until you hear Dancing Queen.
Right. I don't think I could do that.
Dancing
like,
Queen.
You know, look, my soulmate... Looks like my soulmate's not going to be able to, you know, reach up above their head every 3 years because I can't do Layne Staley for the entire run of my life.
I did. Did you?
Hey, is that Sarah calling or Jefferson Starship?
For a soulmate, Tommy's yes, yes.
Wait, Jefferson Starship?
Layne Staley Starship?
Jefferson Airplane?
Oh, okay.
Jefferson space plane.
Exactly.
Jefferson hovercraft.
Jefferson Conan the Star Destroyer.
Mikey
Star Destroyer.
No, nothing.
Mikey.
Whee!
Mikey.
She just.
Huh. What the fuck?
I'm killing your game.
Dude.
Oh,
dude.
Her.
Dude.
Yeah, do you want me to
shit.
Play?
Oh wait,
are
you
doing
the same thing?
I lost it. Man, Mike.
You passed your timer.
I did. I had to stop.
14 hours?
No, 14 minutes. You guys went 14 minutes in a video game marathon without actually playing a video game. I quit playing it a long time ago just to see how long anybody would notice.
I know. I heard you say it. I purposely didn't do anything.
Mike.
Yeah.
Oh, and then Mike had to pick the damn thing up. I just was going to see how long it would take you guys to
realize. There's a...
It doesn't matter, I'm just button mashing.
It don't matter. Well, that's what I was doing too.
Yeah, that's all he was doing.
That's all you can do.
Well, watch out for deer. Yeah,
there's
way
some
out here.
Watch out for snakes.
Bryce says this place is lousy.
Snakes.
Deer lousy.
Severus.
It's like Wookiees.
Little bastard.
This place is lousy with Wookiees. All the wild with them. Alright, guys, I'm gonna. Sleep.
Yeah,
bitch.
Are you on bed?
Double bitch.
Are
you on bed?
Triple bitch.
Can you play this?
Pick it up my shit.
Go to bed.
Good luck. Thanks for coming.
It's like 8 hours
past
my bedtime.
Good hanging
out.
Somebody's
got
to play
some shit.
Huh?
Are
we shut down?
I'm gonna go get it.
What are we doing? We shut down the stream?
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
Somebody's got to help Mike play video games.
I'm not playing games.
Mike's
going
to sleep too.
It's a whole day past my bedtime.
Oh, it's a button masher. There's no story, or if there is
story, you don't know what the fuck's happening.
I just threw my lightsaber in his.
Look, anytime you played, I have no idea what the story is.
Button mash.
That's what I'm doing. Oh, don't press that thing. That's
what Mike's best at, button mashing.
Button masher.
You need some help?
No.
The car with
you coming back tomorrow?
Shit or?
Probably not. Yeah.
Alright.
I got shit to do.
Gotcha.
I still have papers to grade that I was supposed to do.
Oops. I can help you.
Just put a C on all of them.
You got a C.
It's about average. Yeah, that's probably average.
Yeah, try to save Sean.
Good night, Sean. Right,
careful, man.
Love you,
guys.
Be careful, Sean.
Good night.
This is painful. Just give me a
fucking I'm going to sleep.
Just give me a goddamn controller, you fucking noobs. Alright.
Tommy, sauce.
Oh,
good night.
I gotta sleep.
Are you shutting down the stream, by the way?
Want me to?
Not yet.
Let
these two fuckers.
You know how to shut it down, right, Lynn?
Oh, we're fucking. Yeah, I do.
Could stop streaming.
Yeah, I know.
Turn the thing off. Turn the TV off. If you guys need any help, just.
Alright, who's sleeping where? Yeah. I'm probably crashing on whatever couch I end up on.
Yeah. Take a long couch.
Alright. If you're gonna force me.
Crash wherever you can.
I will choke force you.
Ooh, it tastes
you're
good.
Go to bed. We got it taken care of.
Wait. What time is it? We gotta pull the lever in 12 minutes.
I'm not gonna make it.
Yes, you
are. You're a lever.
Yeah.
I got a lever.
Yeah,
right. Right about
we're gonna fuck some pigs.
War pigs?
War pigs.
War pigs have the power. And the god has struck the hour. Death and hatred to mankind.
Death and
poisoning their brainwashed minds. Oh, Lord, yeah.
Good night, guys.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Bo.
Aloha.
Andy. You can drive home all right, right?
Oh, yeah, I can drive just fine. I'll be...
All right.
I'll see you guys in the morning.
You're not driving.
Oh, my God. That's
not
right.
How am I going to drive?
That's not right. He would be better off just crashing here.
He is.
He is fucked up.
He's crashing here.
No, he's gone.
He's from Colorado.
He's gone.
Who, Andy? He's not.
You think he's coming back? Or
he's on the phone. Yeah.
Okay.
He's staying here. This
right,
is where
good.
He's...
Good, good.
This is where he's living for the next few days.
I thought he was just, like, driving back to Colorado tonight. All right,
no,
good.
Oh, no, he's good. He's good. We got him covered.
All right. I mean, I fucked up enough.
Yeah.
No, like, literally. 2 DUIs, fuck that shit.
Yeah, fuck that.
I'm just finally getting over that shit.
Yeah.
And getting my life back in April.
That. Mother bitch! shut up, Sauce. Alright, we'll do the lever.
Well, we're sitting here tonight. Can I pour you?
Yeah, let's do one more.
Alright.
That's
Right. We're staying here tonight. It's good.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm here until fucking Tuesday. I got time.
Well, I'm good. I'm here until tomorrow, but I've got a ride, so I don't have to drive anywhere.
Yeah. Well, I got to figure out my flight information and all that, too, just so I'm prepared. Yeah. Oh, wait. I got to go over here.
Poisoning our brainwashed minds.
Shot time.
Yeah. Or don't.
We're good. Alright.
All right.
This is gay at all.
Gay at all?
This isn't gay at all.
Oh.
Right, pause it.
I think he's a gay
at all. Alright, hey.
6-year-old drinks.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Cheers. Delicious.
We did more last year. I think we did about 1,400.
Yeah, 14 last year. Actually, 1,130 this year.
So far.
Right.
So exactly. Got a day. It pains me to watch. Sauce, you can relate. It really pains
me. Sauce is still around.
To watch people who just button mash these games. That was fortuitous for them. They're just, blah, 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 I don't know what I'm doing. You've been playing it for 8 hours, dude. You should know what you're fucking doing.
Well, look, there's a few of us that have OCD about what exactly is going on.
Ugh, just yeah. Grinds my gears. I don't know what I'm doing.
What are you, Family Guy right now?
Yeah. You've been playing this game for like 8 hours. You should know what the fuck you're doing.
Look, even if I don't, I know enough that I don't know how to play this game, and I will not play it because I don't want to fucking annoy the shit out of anybody that doesn't want to play it.
I haven't played this game in years, but I already beat that part that took them 2 hours.
Now, the point is that if it was a PC version and somebody tried to play this shit and they didn't know what they were doing, I would so be pissed off at them.
The one that you gave to us?
Sweet
Yoda. I didn't give you this.
Yes, you thing. Did.
It's for me to sleep on.
For me to poop on? Son of a bitch. What time we got, Sauce? You're the one paying attention to this crap.
Sauce, you're staying awake, right? Just with us.
You gotta do the lever, though.
What lever?
Lever.
The one,
the time warp lever.
Oh shit, we got to do that. Came close, right?
To what?
Yeah, what time do you have?
Six more minutes, give or take.
Oh my god, it's bigger than my cock.
Eh, well, it's a pretty big lever.
I mean, it's like, it might be twice as heavy as my cock.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about your cock, no offense. I'm sure it's wonderful. What did you do?
Nothing.
Nothing, oh, huh?
The beer can was empty, and we got a couple of Star Wars games, so it's not bad.
That's
all good. Wow, it's like a fucking block of concrete right here. What the fuck? It's like my own cock.
Stop with the cock talk.
Okay.
That's Jesus. The lever.
I did not. The sound was not me.
Was it your cock?
Well, maybe.
Maybe.
I'm trying to lube it up a little bit, but
you know.
Your force is weak, man.
It's way quicker now. My force is the shit.
Your force should be slow and good, not quick.
No, I don't have any complaints.
Well, Leia's told me a bit about you.
Leia hasn't said shit.
Oh, yeah, she has.
Nah, she's a lesbian now.
She loves Ellen, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Her and Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, God, gross.
Weird, gross threesome all the time.
Disgusting. Understandable, but disgusting.
Stop shooting at me, you fuck.
So who's in chat? How many people we got?
We got 5 people in.
Let's hear it. Come on. Show yourselves.
Speak up.
Yes? Where? Let's see it. Have you seen this lever? This lever, if you're from fucking Canada or the European Union.
Hosers. Eh?
Hosers. Come on. We've got a time warp to do.
What time is it?
Oh, shit. What time is it?
2 minutes?
We've got, yeah, exactly 2 minutes.
It's because he said 2 minutes.
What, a Jedi, a Sith? What?
No, he did.
We got 2 minutes. Come on. Let's hear it. Come on, let's go. Time warp.
2 minutes and counting, Sauce.
Let's go. How many seconds? You're saying 60. That means a minute, right?
Exactly a minute.
Well, that was like 10 seconds ago.
Wow. Balls.
Balls indeed. Come on, let's do it. So we're doing this time warp thing.
Yup.
Let's go. Got 30. Come on. Come on. We're doing it.
Wait, hold up. In about...
We got time. Set 30.
Hold up. All right. Call it.
Come on. Oh, he's got 10.
10 seconds.
Drop that controller. Come on.
You're doing it.
Oh.
You got the honors.
With this beautiful, like...
Yeah, that's dirty. Alright, go. Time warp. There we go. That hurt the couch. That hurt you?
The hell did you do?
No, I'm good.
That sounded painful.
No. Yeah, that was cinematic.
Alright. Daylight savings. Awesome. Now it's 3 o'clock, but it's really 2 o'clock. We're good.
Time traveling.
What? What do you... What's that? What? We pulled the lever.
Well, yeah, we time traveled.
And my phone hasn't... Because it's 2 a.m. now, right?
No.
It goes forward.
Well, check your clock in like 5 minutes.
Well, it should have popped immediately.
That's what I say to women all the time. You should have popped immediately. Right?
I guess so.
Well, you know.
Alright, we're going to save this and I'm done. I'm going to bed.
Before you go to bed, let's have a shot. If you're going to bed anyway, let's have a shot.
Nah, I'm done.
No, I know
when I'm done.
If you're going to bed anyway,
no,
let's have a shot.
It's not going to help me.
Well, I'm not saying it's going to help you.
It's not going to help you either.
Oh, it is. It will totally help me to sleep better.
So you can take it. I'm good. That's kind of odd.
1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Do you know these numbers? Or no?
Do a Fibonacci code or something?
It is the Fibonacci sequence.
No, nothing about that.
You lying ass motherfucker.
I made that up. I just got lucky.
Did you know the Fibonacci sequence?
Yeah, it's all, what, prime numbers?
It's not just prime numbers. Because it changes after a
certain time. Oh, yeah, no, it's not prime numbers.
It's not.
Add the previous one to...
Right.
Yeah, so 1, 2, then 3, then 5, then 8,
but
then...
It's flowers and everything.
It's everything.
Yes, it is everything.
We can't see that, by the way, Sauce.
So, besides Andy drinking the Four Loko, he's talking about how he smokes cigarettes and how he's quitting and everything.
Yeah, everybody says they're quitting and they're fucking dead.
Well, here's the deal. I brought one pack with me, and I'm 2/3 of the way through. And Andy said, oh yeah, I'm quitting and all this kind of shit. He brought 2 packs of cigarettes tonight, and he smoked like fucking a half pack last night. I was like, I didn't want to say anything. I was like, dude. Really?
Pay attention to that shit.
Yeah, I'm still at my regular of less than 5 cigarettes a day. But I think that he wants to smoke a shit ton more. And what's ridiculous is that his girlfriend was flirting with me like fucking crazy today.
Okay.
And I did not like that.
How was she flirting with you? And she was on that FaceTime call for about 30 seconds?
Yeah, and she was like, oh, I like tall guys.
Okay.
Cute. She tells me she likes tall guys and she likes them cute. And she's like, what's your name? All this kind of shit when I was talking to fucking... It pissed me off because she is supposed to like him.
Yeah, I'm sure she lives in Colorado with him. Yeah, I mean,
that's not the point. I don't give a fuck. It's like, why the fuck are you flirting with me? Fuck you. I don't like that.
Okay. I have nothing to do with it.
Well, I have nothing to do with it either.
I don't know anything about it.
I don't either. But yeah, pissed me off.
She wasn't just being friendly.
No. She was totally cheating on him tonight.
I don't know about all that.
No, she was...
That's a bit drastic.
No, she was with another guy.
Fuck that guy up.
She was with another guy tonight. There is no doubt in my mind that she was with another guy tonight.
Okay. Well...
I would never fuck that shit up. I'm just saying. He loves her more than he should.
That's none of my business. You know? It's none I don't feel comfortable even talking about it, to be honest. None of my business. I ain't gonna even. Yeah. I didn't see him half naked on a website, so.
Right.
Hey!
Sean lived too?
Yeah, Sean.
Where were you at?
You didn't see him walk out.
I think I probably saw him leaving. Does he drive a truck?
I don't fucking remember. But we're saving this. I'm done. I don't know about you.
Yeah, I'm going to sleep.
Yeah, where?
On the mattress.
Yeah, with Mike.
Yeah. Why, did you want to?
No, I'm not gonna. I'm sleeping right here on his couch.
Oh, okay.
I just figured you didn't know he was in there or something.
Oh, yeah, no. He said he'd sleep with me.
Took a long couch.
Did he?
Oh, yes, he did. I had to get permission from the girlfriend, of course.
Wait, from his or yours?
Right.
All right, well, I'm going to bed, so I'm going to go walk in there real quick, take a leak, brush my teeth, and then I'm passing the fuck out on this couch.
Take the long couch. I'm taking either this one or that one.
That's up to you.
Oh, no. That's you.
Oh.
We have all to right. Do the time warp, though.
We just did.
Did we?
You pulled the lever.
Well, no.
You dance, you mean?
Nobody saw it, though.
Cigarette pretty sauce. Sure that Sauce saw it.
Yeah, Sauce was there.
Oh yeah, he was there.
We can do the dance of the time warp tomorrow.
What just happened here?
I'm ready for a cigarette. You?
Oh, I just went.
Oh, you bastard.
I know, I'm sorry.
Bitch.
Where is this?
Sorry.
It's fine. It's fine.
I had two out there, so otherwise I would go with you.
You had two?
I had two.
You are a fucking cunt.
I know.
Whoa,
I know.
Bro.
You dick.
Is anybody watching still?
What?
Is anybody watching still?
Oh, yeah.
Did we beat the game, by the way? Is it done? Did I finally beat this stupid game?
No, you did not.
Because it looks like we beat it.
Well,
that's
you didn't
that's
beat
the
it. Sean may have.
Okay, that's the
not.
Intro. Okay. Yeah, Sean, by the way, could have relinquished control at any time.
Oh, yeah.
And I was telling Sauce.
He does that to himself every
Sean
time.
Sauce may agree.
Angry
it is bastard. Painful to watch somebody button mash the fucking game that I could have beaten in an hour. Okay?
Yeah, that's Sean. Yes.
Oh. Yep.
That does not mean that he did not enjoy it.
No, he did not enjoy it.
No, yes, no.
Temporarily.
And tortures himself.
As angry as
not
it gets and torturous as it gets, he still enjoys it.
Well.
He does. He does. Alright, I'm out of cigarettes.
I didn't hear any of the last conversation except for, alright, I'm going
what?
To have a cigarette.
Cigarette? Oh, I'll have the time machine in my pocket. Do you have a cigarette? Maybe.
Say what now?
Oh, I'm looking for a cigarette.
Oh, okay.
I have shipments from you at this point. Found it?
Huh?
Found it?
Found what?
Your stuff.
Yeah, I knew exactly where I left it.
Okay.
Alright, after this trip, started at the gym again.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm not just saying that, I'm doing that.
We all are.
We can tell you a workout.
No, I don't.
Yeah, bullshit.
I haven't worked out in years.
What would you like to say, Darth? E.T. for Atari 2600 doesn't suck that bad.
We are not playing E.T. Don't ever mention that word again. That is a swear word here. You were not here last year, Darth. Or the year before. That was terrible times.
Terrible.
El terrible. Yeah, I have not worked out in 2 years.
Alright, Andy, I'm stealing a cigarette from you.
Okay, go for it. I got two packs, so.
You going out?
You got
no,
two
I'm
packs.
Not.
Alright.
I'm waiting on Boba.
There is no Boba.
To finish destroying the bathroom so I can go.
You're
going to
be waiting like 10 hours.
I really wasn't going to destroy it. I was just going to change
cigarette?
And brush my teeth.
Yeah, they're in my jacket. In the front.
Right there?
Yeah, the front pocket, the breast pocket. Feel free to take whenever, however.
Whenever, however.
Is that one mine or is that that's yours?
That's not mine.
No, mine's on the chair.
This one?
Should be. Whichever one smells like smoke. That'd be
you, and, you and I are the only ones that smell
right.
like smoke.
Exactly. Yeah, that front breast pocket.
Oh, I kind of feel it. Yes.
There you go.
Somewhere. This is like a secret trap.
Yeah, I know,
that's
right?
A trap.
I love it. Yeah, we played it a couple marathons, Darth, previous to this one.
And the lighter's also in the blue jacket?
Yeah. Did you lose your lighter too?
No, it's in my jacket, but.
Yeah, it's in the, it's in the front breast pocket too.
Yeah.
I don't even know if you can see that. Oh yeah, I'm playing it. I'm beating it, and it's going well. And yeah.
You want a shot?
Oh yeah.
That's a yes.
No.
I heard the sarcasm in your voice.
Yeah. Shot. A shot of a bed. Sounds wonderful.
Shot.
Some wonderful music, and then everybody can nap with you.
I guess we're going now. We're not having a
turn
sleep
off.
Sleep.
Yeah. My man.
Yeah, we're gonna turn the stream off, guys.
Oh, okay.
And yeah, the clocks haven't changed back to 2 yet, so
let me see.
We haven't gained or lost anything, really.
You got possibly Archie, Jordan, Sauce, Spider Freak.
No, Spider Freak. That's Justin.
And Darth still
shut
watching.
This fucker off.
They may want to nap with you.
Really?
That's what I did last night.
We can turn the stream off, though, but keep nice chat on, right?
Oh, yeah. Chat will always be on. All right. Yeah. Old people nap good time again. Oh, yeah. Early morning.
You guys want to, you know, keep the stream on so you can watch me play with my phone until I pass out.
Yeah, I mean, they can vote if anybody's there. Do you want to leave the stream on, or we can cut it?
Leave the stream on.
What'd you say?
Leave the stream on.
See, that's what I say.
Yeah. Whether we're sleeping or not, whatever.
No, just turn it off. Well, it's not
really?
Just turn it off.
Damn.
All right, we're turning it off.
Good night, everybody. See you in the morning.
We're turning it off. Stuff. We're good.
All right, what about the lighting?
I'll turn it off in a second.
You know how to do all that shit?
Yes, I do. I got it. Ready?
Not ready anymore.
All right.
That's easy.
And this one?
And now TV remote. Where's that at?
Done.
I'm gonna leave all that stuff on. Do we have TV remotes?
Yeah, small micro remote. Okay. But we have to find that with light.
Well, I haven't seen it all night.
So. I'll turn it back on.
Over there, possibly. It's no remotes here, but the Wii remote.
Oh, this one right here. So,
yeah, TV's off. Okay, and then.
Just hit power.
It only works for that.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I got this. You know where the thing is on that?
Are we cutting the stream?
Yeah, everything should be on. Okay. Thought Andy already did it.
No, I can stop the stream.
Yeah. Don't cross the streams either.